Hey everyone, I'm Vikram Salunke and welcome to the another video of x86 assembly. In the last video, we saw C to assembly in slides. In this video, we'll take the same C program, compile them in Visual Studio, then debug them. After that, we see the generated assembly code and then modification of stack, registers, etc. So let's get started. Let's look at our C program first. You can download this program from GitHub. I'll give the link in the description box below. This is the same C program which we saw in the last video. First, we'll start with the main. Main is calling function. Then we'll go to the function. Function returning with tools. After that, function returning to main. And main is returning with one and program ends here. Okay, let's see the program in Visual Studio. We have already seen how to create a project and how to set project properties. I'll give the link of that video in the I button. This is a C program. First, we'll build it. To build that, click on build, build solution. Okay, it is saying build succeeded. Now we will debug it, but before debugging, we will place a breakpoint here. Then we'll click on debug. Okay, now we'll right click and click on go to disassembly. This is our C code with the assembly language instructions. As you can see here, arrow indicates the current stop location. We can treat this like an EIP, that is a next instruction to be executed. In this side, we can see all the registers. To view all the registers, click on debug, windows, registers. To view the memory, click on debug, windows, memory, memory one. Here we can see the memory. First, we will right click here. We want to view the memory as 4 byte integer. Click 1 here. After that, we'll click this to the ESP and we will click on this to re-evaluate automatically. That means when the stack changes, it will always point to the ESP. Okay, just move this memory onto the right hand side. So we can see registers and stack together. To go to the next instruction, we'll click on this step into. Then this arrow will move on to the next instruction. This is our assembly code. The first few instructions are as usual, as we are setting the stack frame for the main onto the stack. Let's execute that. Click on step into. And now, as we can see in the register, the red color indicates that its value has been changed. EIP changed as usual because we have moved from 00401010 to 00401011, and value of ESP has been decremented because we have pushed the value of EBP onto the stack. Next instruction is we'll move ESP to the EBP. So the ESP is 0012FF68 that will be moved into the EBP. Let's execute that instruction using step into. Okay, as we can see, ESP and EBP both contains the same value because we have just moved ESP into the EBP. Next instruction is we are calling function. For that, first we will push the next instruction address onto the stack. Let's click on step into. And as we can see, the next instruction address has been pushed onto the stack. And now we are executing from function. And the first two lines are as usual. We are pushing the EBP onto the stack to save the stack frame pointer of a main onto the stack. And we are moving ESP into the EBP to start the function stack frame. Okay, let's execute push EBP by clicking step into. So 0012FF68, that is a value of a main stack frame pointer, has been pushed onto the EBP. Now we'll move ESP into the EBP. Let's click on step into. And ESP 0012FF60, that has been moved into EBP, that is 0012FF60. Next, we are returning with 2. So we will move those 2s into the EAX. Let's step into that. As we can see, EAX register contains 2s. Now the function ends here. For that, First, we will pop the value pointed by the ESP onto the EBP to give back main its own stack frame pointer. Let's tap into that. And value pointed by the ESP has been moved into the EBP. So 0012FF68 is now in EBP. Next, we are returning to main. For that, what we'll do, we'll pop the top of the stack, that is 00401018, and we will put that into the EIP. Okay, so now EIP 00401009, we will put that into the EIP, and EIP will move on to the 00401018. Okay, let's step into that. As we can see, EIP is now on to the 00401018, and we will start execution from there. Now main is returning with the ones. For that, we will move ones into the EAX. Let's step into that. Okay, now EAX contains ones. We are ending main function here. For that, we will pop top of the stack into the EBP. Top of the stack is 0012FFB8 because we want to give the function who called main its own stack frame pointer back. Step into that. Okay, that value has been moved into the EBP. Now we are returning from main, and this is our return location, that is on the top of the stack, that is 00401028. We will pop that location and put that into the EIP, and EIP will begin execution from there. Let's step into that. Okay, so as we can see, main has returned to its initialization function. So we will stop our debugging from here. To stop the debugging, click on this stop debugging icon. Okay, so that's it for this video. On the right hand side, you can find all the videos of x86 assembly language. And if you have any doubts, any feedback, you can contact me on following handles. Thank you.